So welcome back to my channel. This is Dom and an update on some of the painting projects I've been working on. Lot of ships been done. Nearly said that wrong. Lot of ships been done recently. Mainly because I've got quite into Victory at Seas and I wanted to paint up the fleets I've got. And also they are very easy to paint and quite fun to paint. And very simple to paint as well, if I'm honest. So I, as you may have seen, I've already got the Kriegsmarine fleet, which Warlords kindly gave me some time ago when they were due to come on the podcast, but never actually did, but I've still got the figures out of it, so all good. And I bought a few extra ships on top because Dom's Dom, and I can't stop buying models, particularly when I've really enjoyed this game. But I also picked up the Victory at Sea starter set. Somebody was selling it through Facebook, actually, for an absolute steal. I mean, real serious steal. Unopened. So I picked it up because I thought having two fleets would be really useful, and indeed I think it's going to be, because I'm supposed to be playing with Jono at some point, and he hasn't got any ships yet. So at least if I take the Americans or the Japanese along, he can overpay Germans, them, whatever. We've got options to play, which will be good until he builds a fleet. So this is all the starter box, which I painted up. So this is the American cruisers. You've got the, what have we got? The Chicago, Indianapolis, and the Northampton cruisers, which I think are sort of light medium cruisers in this game. Certainly the Indianapolis is a smaller lightweight cruiser, the other two slightly bigger. Nice models. Now I have to say I got a bit complacent with the Kriegsmarine. They were really nice to put together. I mean, they're fiddly. They give you little tiddly bits which are really fiddly. But at least with the German fleet, they're metal. But these, they're the stupid Warlord resin, which is really hard to tidy up and really difficult to stick down. So even these little, I don't know what they are here, these bits here on the sides of the ships, they're separate and you have to try and stick them on there. And it, oh, God, these things nearly got launched across the room several occasions. And I just don't know why they have to make it so darn fiddly. But it is what it is, and they're done, and you know, they're not the best, but they'll do me. So next up, this is six American Fletcher class destroyers that you get in the box, starter box. Don't know why you get, you know, you get six American destroyers, you get three Japanese destroyers, and you get three American cruisers, and you get three Japanese cruisers. So I imagine the Japanese ones a lot better, a lot higher points wise, if that's the case. And certainly I think that most of their cruisers are quite big, which probably explains the disparity in numbers. Again these were quite easy to paint up, good fun to do. Yeah, there's not much to them. They've got a couple of dinghies, or I don't know what they are on the side, probably lifeboats of some sorts. Apart from that, it really isn't much defining detail on these. And they didn't really have much to stick down, which was a bonus as well, because the cruisers were a nightmare. So pleased to get them done. And that's the American destroyer fleet ready. And these are the Japanese destroyers, the Fubuki class destroyers. You get three of them in the box. All I've done really is looking at the illustrations. Most of them seem to have a sort of, I don't know, it's actually wooden, but a wooden coloured deck. Most of the images I've seen, so that's what I've followed with all my Japanese ships. I haven't tried to do camo. Again, there's so many different images you see that I think you could decide they could have camo, or you, maybe they don't have camo, because sometimes they did, sometimes they didn't. So none of mine are going to have camo, mainly also because they're fiddly as hell to do, because there isn't actually an awful lot of distance between the waterline and the ships to paint any camo, certainly not to my eyesight. So those are the Fubukis. Apparently Japanese torpedoes are something to behold, so I'm quite looking forward to seeing them in action. So finally, these are the three Japanese cruisers. You've got the Kumano, the Mugami, and the Furutaka. I think the Furutaka is a light cruiser. I think these two are heavy cruisers. Same as the Americans, that stupid wall of resin for all the sort of coning towers and guns and what have you. It was fiddly as hell to put together. And I've just I noticed that actually this gun hasn't gone on straight because I had so much trouble sticking them down properly. The combination of the harder resin and the Warlord's resin, getting them to stick when they're fiddly as anything, was really tedious. So I'd much rather they'd stuck with metal for the... sorry, my phone just keeps pinging. I'd much rather they used the metal for the all the extras, but for this starter pack they apparently use that horrible resin. But there you go, I followed again the same template. So the Japanese will have the sort of wooden looking deck, whereas the German, the Americans have basically grey all the way over, because it appears to be what their ships look like. So that is the Victory at Sea starter box completed. Only took me a few days, and was actually a joy to do. So having done all those American and Japanese ships, I thought it was vital for my Kriegsmarine that I up-armed that fleet with the Graf Zeppelin aircraft carrier. So this is a sort of semi-fictitious ship. It was actually built in the war. It was Germany recognised it needed an aircraft carrier to extend its air cover into the oceans. Laid down this design, was supposed to be, I believe, the start of a class of ships. They built one. It was launched at the beginning of the war, but was never outfitted and never commissioned. At the time when it was ready to be commissioned, Hitler had lost faith in the Kriegsmarine surface fleet, and basically put all the resources into submarines and to other areas of the war. And so the hull was never commissioned. So this is a sort of what-if ship in the war, in the Victory at Sea fleet. And I just thought it was fun to have. So... yeah, it's a big old slice of resin. Nice model, not too fiddly. It's gone back to having, there's not many bits that you add in, but there were about three different sort of fiddly bits you stick on, but they were all metal, which makes it so much easier than those horrible resin things. I've just painted the flight deck with a sand colour and then washed it. The side have just kept really simple, just a dark grey, and just weathered a lighter grey on. I presume this is some sort of launch mechanism on the ship for the aircraft, but I've just basically used a lighter grey there, and then just washed it and dry brushed it with a sort of very pale deck tan colour, and then the ocean done exactly the same way as I've shown on all the other ships I've been doing. Really quite pleased with it. It's a massive ship. I mean, it really is a big piece of resin. Not bad value, actually. Really not bad value for the compared to some of the other warships in the fleet. Also, I've already got some planes, but I bought another flight of Focke-Wulf 109 fighter bombers to accompany it. Now, I haven't used aircraft carriers yet in Victory at Seas, so I don't know what's going to be the best sort of planes to use, or composition to use, or how many how many flights you're allowed on a ship. So I need to work that through. The planes were a little bit fiddly, a bit disappointing, I guess. I mean, it's a shame they didn't do the stands on sort of clear bases. Because you've got an awful lot of plastic with just little tiny models on the top, but whatever. they're not really that important in the great scheme of things. So I've just painted mine blue because I think they'll hopefully sort of camouflage a bit into the mat that I'm using for the game. That's the only reason why I did it that way. And the planes, I've just probably can't see it, but I just did a very sort of camo green on the wings and the fuselage, and then picked out the cockpit and the sort of nose where the propeller would be for the plane in a yellow, yeah, it works. So that's a bit of an upgrade to the German fleet. So it seems like everything on the Monday Night Plastic Crack podcast has gone dead man's hands at the moment, the Western Skirmish game. I think it's mainly because of those plastic cowboy set that Great Escape Games brought out, which by all accounts are fantastic. But it got me sort of finished thinking, well, let's me work through some of the ones I've bought from them. But these are metal. This is their Plains Indian set, seven models, all metal. And really nice, fun to do, enjoyed doing them. I think this last period I've kind of just got away from doing mass battalions of infantry and kind of just like doing a few special figures or just small groups of figures just for a variety. And it's always a good idea. I mean, people talk about their mojo and getting burnt out painting figures. Well, you know, just swap it up. Don't do a big battalion. Do a few specialist figures, or do some vehicles, or whatever it is. Just keep your sort of motivation going, and that's what I've done recently. I think I'm halfway through a battalion of Russian Napoleonic infantry, but I just kind of wanted to do some different stuff, so that's what I've been doing. These were great fun. Really enjoyed doing them. I've even strung the bows on the two archers. That one's a bit flappy, which is a shame. I try and tighten that up somehow, but that's just using the thread from Black Seas rigging, the notorious Black Seas rigging, but you could just use any kind of cotton. And there you go, that's the Plains Indians ready to join Black Man's Dead Man's Hand whenever I get around to actually having a game of that system. So next up, single figure. This is one of those Giants in Miniatures, or Giants of Miniatures special figures that War Games Illustrated do. They make 500 of them and they destroy the mold. This guy, I don't know where I picked him up. I really don't know where I picked him up. Probably at a show somewhere. This is Alan Quatermain, the Hunter figure, and I just thought I'd use him as a Dead Man's Hand character. So because he's armed with a shotgun, he's got a floppy hat and a long trench coat, so he's going to join my good guys on the Dead Man's Hand posses. So there you go, not much more to say about him. It was fun to do. So I really don't know where I got him from or why I got him. I was probably buying a couple of others of them at the same time and just thought, well, he looks fun, and picked him up. Not that I was ever going to do any sort of African hunter games, but as I say, he'll do as a Western character for me. So finally, these are three more Dead Man's Hands characters. These are from Crusader Miniatures. They're a little bit small. If I put them beside this guy, you can see they're a little bit small. But they're very nice little models. This is, I think they call them the Foreigners or something like that. You've got Mad Jock, Scottish guy with two pistols. Alfonso suggests he's Italian, but I've painted him up as a Franco-Prussian guy. And then I think this one's Otto, Baron Otto, who's wearing a breastplate. I just thought they'd be a fun, imagine. You know, I could put some special rules into Dead Man's Hands for Otto, that the breastplate or the cuirass he's wearing gives him some kind of extra saving throw. Mad Jack. Mad Jock is just such a brilliant character. I've got to use him. Can't quite see on the probably on the camera, but I did sort of do a bit of tartan on his kilt. But he's just such a characterful figure. Really, really nice figure to use. Alfonso, I'm quite pleased with how he came out. I was almost tempted to take him and put him with my Franco-Prussian figures. But in the end, I decided to keep him there. He's got a sabre, so I'd imagine in Dead Man's Hand we can make him quite a good melee figure. He's also got a pistol in his holster, so he's all sorted out. So yeah, really good, really nice little figures. I think I bought these when North Star were doing a sale, and they were selling them off really cheap, and I just thought they were a bit of fun. When I was starting out building my Dead Man's Hand characters. And so really pleased, got them painted up and really pleased with the effect of them. So there you go. So there you go. That's what I've been up to. Well, I've been up to a bit more, but I'll show them off on another occasion. My samurai fetish. As I said in the video, I've kind of had a weird phase. I've kind of not been so keen to do big battalions of troops, which is a bit of a shame because I was halfway through a Russian Napoleonic infantry battalion. I'll get that finished off, but just sometimes you just have to change it up. I wanted to get those Victory at Sea fleets done to play a game with Jonathan, which was great, and you'll see the video of that at some point when I finish editing it. And then just sort of different character figures. All these Dead Man's Hand figures have been great fun to do. There's a couple of others I haven't bothered to show that I've done, which were sort of the odd Napoleonic officers and so forth, just because they're just because I happened to have them and I needed them just to sort of add a big man or something like that. But as I said earlier, it's I think there's a really good way of keeping your mojo. Keeping yourself motivated. If you're having a bit of a slide, just change to something different. Do some vehicles, in my case ships. Do some single figures, some characters, small groups, rather than going wading in with the big battalions, just to keep things fresh. Anyway, hope you like this look at what I've been working on. I hope your projects are doing well. I hope you're staying safe. In the UK, I hope you're avoiding this torrential rain at the moment. Maybe people's painting has jumped up a level because of it. Anyway, stay safe, stay well, and I'll see you again soon. This is Dom, signing out. Oh, don't forget, hit that subscribe, hit that like. Please, if you can, really helps. And I look forward to comments in the comment section. See you later.